What's good, people? Dribble Inc. And as promised, I was going to show you my setup before I moved out into the living room and set up out there so I could start recording with the Wii as well. Currently, I have two 360s, PS3, and the Wii in the living room. And because that Wii has that one attachment that runs across the top of the TV, I kind of have to keep it out there. That and my kids play the Wii out there, so wouldn't make sense for me to bring it in here and hog it up while I'm recording 360 or PS3 and, you know, no one else getting to play it, because that's mainly what my wife and kids play. So what I wanted to show you is kind of like my setup here before I actually moved out to the living room and kind of like did a comparison. Well, not a comparison, but a before and after. I'm hoping it goes well. Anytime you make a move like that, you got to really game plan and think about shit that could go wrong, like the sound. You want to make sure, and because when I record here, I can isolate the sound because I have like two monitors, and so in the living room it's just one monitor and one sound output. So, you know, it's just a lot of shit I got to think about, but I have, and hopefully everything works out great. So. So anyways, this is my original 360. I've had this for a long time. It has had special things done to it. So that's mainly the one I use to record. PS3 Slim, 250 gig, I believe. And I have the Wii out in the living room along with I have the 360 Slim as well. Or the what do they call it? The short 360 Squat. Whatever, you know, the new one, and also 250 gigs as well, and that's where, like, I mainly play multiplayer games with all my buddies and whatnot, and a lot of people complain that I didn't play PS3 enough, and, you know, I agreed with them because I didn't, and so for this go-around, instead of playing, you know, online or Black Ops online on my 360 where I normally play my COD games, I decided to buy it here first for PS3, and then eventually, here in a couple weeks, I'm actually going to pick it up for the 360, that way I can start playing with some of my old friends and whatnot. That is my favorite band of all time, Mars Volta. Got that autographed a few years back. Fucking love that band to death. If you have never heard of them, look them up, listen to those cats, man. They're fucking mind-blowing. At least their first two albums. They're kind of getting a little crazy lately, but you know, you guys probably heard of them. Alright, so this 19-inch screen is what I mainly play on. And this 20-inch is where I watch where I'm recording. So I'll put up, like, you know, I'll come up here and pull out the where the hot pog is, and I watch the recording, make sure everything went smoothly and whatnot. And, you know, it's just easy for me to have two things I can watch at the same time. That's kind of the thing that's going to suck when I go to the living room, because I'm going to have to, like, use my remote to go in between both. But whatever. It's not going to be too much of a hassle. Here's my hot pog. Had it for a while. I think I've had it for, like, 2 years. I remember when I first got it, no one really had them. Or nobody was really recording with them. Everybody was still using dazzles and whatnot. And I originally bought it for like $250 something. When it was priced a little higher, I think. And there's only like two guys who had a tutorial for it. So, goes to show how long I've been using it. But now they're pretty popular. That one and the, what do you call it, the Black Intensity Pro is what I think John uses for next-gen walkthroughs, and a lot of people use. And Hotbox, actually, I don't know if you knew this, but PSN Girl told me that they're coming out with a new capture card that's going to be internal. I forgot what they call it, like the Colossus or the something. Anyways, it's going to be just like the Black Intensity Pro, and I'm going to be picking that up. That way I could do live streams. So that's going to be fun, and I guess I'll be doing it out there. But, yeah, so definitely look for that in the future and whatnot. Up here I have
a couple of pieces of art from, I got those two from a tattoo convention in Austin. Back when I used to hang out in tattoo shops a lot and work in one, we'd always go to the conventions every year. And it, the great thing about going to those conventions is there's a lot of artists there. And I say that even though it's kind of silly that, you know, to think that there wouldn't be tattoo artists in a, or excuse me, artists in a tattoo art convention. But a lot of people have this distinction that tattoo artists are not artists. And I have no idea where that comes from, but it's kind of, I guess, from people's experiences going to like really shitty shops and seeing like really shitty work, I would agree and say that a lot of those guys aren't artists too. So, anyways, so I got those pretty rad shit, right? Let me see here. This I got from, I bought the game and they gave me a shirt. I think it's a shirt. I've never opened it, so I don't know. Signed baseball from the Championship Yankees. And they're not real autographs, but, you know, I gotta represent, right? Big Willie, bobblehead, a few Blu-ray DVDs. I stopped buying these because I think that within a few years, digital media is going to be the way to go. And physical media is probably in about 5 years is going to be obsolete. So I stopped buying it together and I just buy it online now. This is where I keep all my games. I'm not a big fan of holding on to, like, you know, these things are what, the physical part. I just take out the DVD or just the DVD, the game, and just put it in here and do whatever with it. That and all my other special games go in there too. Trying to think. Oh, one of the problems with the hot pot, I'm gonna show you something real quick. I don't know if you see, it's kind of dark back there, but when you plug in the Hophog, when you plug in like your PS3, if you want to go from PS3 to 360, unless if you don't have a receiver, you have to constantly plug in and out. And so now that I'm gonna have to deal with three consoles, I'm gonna have like three different things I'm gonna have to constantly plug in and out. That kind of sucks, but I did try to solve it by getting this thing here. I don't know if you can see it well, but the idea was that this was going to go in the back of the Hophog. It's a component. And that I was going to put one of my PS3 connections in the top row, 360 connection in the bottom row. Problem, though, is when I hooked it up, the PS3 really did not like this extra thing. And it made for a really, really shitty video. So I had to toss it. And this wasn't, it was like $4, so it wasn't like a huge investment or anything, but I was just trying to think outside the box. Maybe I'll end up picking up a receiver, but that's kind of my fear, is that even if I have the receiver, that might not work either, so who the fuck knows? I may just keep it like it is now. What else? Computer. It's a Hewlett-Packard, nothing special. It's a go-getter, really. It just does the job. In February, I'm going to upgrade the memory and the video card. That way, I could just start rendering faster. Because right now, rendering's it's getting old. That it's slow. I don't know if that made sense, but you know, when you get used to something for such a long time, like when I record like a 10-minute HD video, it usually takes me like 30 minutes to render. But I want it faster. I want 10-minute rendering times, 5-minute rendering times. I want it to be just super fast. So, books. I freaking love books. And I read, actually, let me bore you out to death real quick. I have, like, some really cool shit here that if you guys are really into reading and philosophy and all that stuff, or even, like, quantum physics and stuff, Carl Sagan. This is a great book by Paul Davies called About Time. It's about time, but in the quantum universe. What else do I got? Super String Theory. Really mind-blowing stuff. This book was given to me here. It doesn't have the spine on it, but basically it's called Dancing Woolly Masters. And it's by this guy named Zhukov, Gary Zhukov. And basically he talks about how the quantum universe and the what am I trying to say? Quantum universe and Buddhism, that's what, Zen Buddhism, are so closely mended together that a lot of the old Buddhist disciples have been saying a lot of these things that quantum physicists have been saying. Anyways, I'm boring you guys to death, but but it's a good shit, man. If you guys are really into books, you need some recommendations, just hit me up, and I have really good shit to read. If you want my points and tips. And some of those books up there are my wife's, by the way. So don't get it confused, son. I don't read erotica. That's her book. So that's it. Just wanted to show you guys that real quick. And next video I will do probably by this weekend if I have set up everything in by that time. And then I'll show you what I've done out there and how everything's going out there. So that's it. I'll see you guys in some future videos. Peace.